was studying in Estonia, and then one of my classmates, her parents live in one of these skyscrapers, so she showed me some pictures of the place, and we decided to go because I was impressed of the images of the place. And then we came to the family. I didn't know like if they will be okay with the screening, if the shooting. So we stayed with them 2 days, and after that we started to shoot. I explained them how I would like to do, and then basically started the whole process. The hardest part, I would say, maybe it was the distance and the budget, because you always have to plan very precisely when you go and when you want to shoot and what you want to shoot. So this was the hardest thing, and then of course like the whole process of like post-production and everything, and when to finish the film and etc. Yeah, that's a good question. If they are heroes, or if they are against, let's say, society or something. For me, definitely they are heroes, because if it would be in different conditions and there should be built something for the society, then maybe you could think more in a way that they are against something which is going to be served to the society. But in this case, when there should be another just money made building, then it's totally like against the system. I believe that they are still like part of the society, because on one hand they was there on this place, so you can't say they are not part of the society, because the society was built around them, the new one, so they became. And the question is like always like in such a situations, how you gonna treat them? Like there should be some urbanist, there should be plans for future. So if you want to resettle the village, they should know that there will be city, so they can choose like I would like to stay and live, or I have to move because there is already plans that I should be compensated. So like this city happens to be like part of the skyscraper society, or how to say. I think it's this never-ending optimism, which is very hard to find nowadays, like especially in Central Europe and maybe all around the world, that people lost their energy to fight for something they believe. And when I saw this place, I was first amazed, like, how the hell is possible that this place exists, and who are the people who are protecting this place, and are they on the right or bad side, or how is it? And when I found out Natasha, understood the situation, I was really impressed how powerful she is, and how she can fight for something that she believes. Yeah, that's a question which you will be never answered, because the real truth is somewhere in between. But for sure, this program is always like this. I saw some other parts of the different topics, and they always like do it as a show. There were couples like gays and lesbians, and then big guy and very small girl, or vice versa, and they always like made it show out of this. But it's true that by that time the owner of this TV was an oligarch, and he owned also the building companies, so you can't never know like if it was on purpose or not. But I believe that the guy didn't say like, okay, let's pick up this woman because I want her place. If he would do it different way, definitely. I think this was more about to really make fun of her in front of others, and they felt it would be great option, because she will be alone there. I have to say that I still live with them in a way, because I always, when I'm in Ukraine, I come to them and I visit them. So I still continue to follow them. We became real friends during the shooting, during these 5 years. And I believe that even if they will move from the place, that we still be in contact, because also of the oldest daughter, she's living outside the city, on the outskirts, and with her I'm also in contact. So basically, like, yeah, it was like visiting my relatives always. To be honest, it's one of the most delighted festivals of the atmosphere, and it's somehow connected the city and the people and the concerts and everything. It's so is done very nice way, which is not pushing you that you have to see all the films or there is like special program just for you and etc. So I felt also from the people that they really enjoy, and I mean the selection of the film I also enjoyed about what was inside. So from my point of view, it's one of the very heart-touching festivals.